Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Good afternoon, everybody. How is your day going and how was service today? Hope you were in his presence. Hallelujah. In my own church, the Lord moved mightily. I just want to testify to what the Lord has done in my family, because when we are grateful to God for what he's done, he does more. And also to advise us to know what's going on, because it's really, 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 it is just God that has done this. It is the Lord that has done this. You know, God actually delivered my niece from death, 2 years old niece. You know, my younger brother's daughter, she's two. And the thing is this, in Nigeria, my mom's house, when we built the house for her, she called the electrician that wired the house. We don't know nothing about that. But the thing is this, the house was badly wired, unknown to us. And my mom lived in that house for years. When I go home, that is where I stay. I stay with my mom. I stay nowhere else but with my mom when I went home. And my younger brother, unknown to us, the guy that wired the house, kind of took the cable through the protector, took the cable through the protector in the house, and used just bedroom slippers to wedge it. So there was the bedroom slippers staying in between the electrical cable and the protector. And this is how my mom's house was wired for years, unknown to us. We never checked. We didn't even check. It was just God's grace that has been protecting everybody in the house. And so my niece, my couple of weeks ago, my younger brother's daughter, she's two, went outside to play and then just touched the gate. Now, what happened is this. The bedroom slippers that the electrician put separating the cables from the protector has been eaten by electricity. And so the cable was directly touching the protector. The protector outside the house. And this little girl went out to play, touched the gate, and she got electrocuted. She was there dying. The mother just realized that, oh, where's my daughter? She came out and saw her child practically dying before her eyes. And she shouted, I'm so grateful to God for this deliverance, because if not God, as a mother, before we could even think, you would go, you want to save your child, and you both die there. But she shouted, and there was a tenant in the house that came out. And the tenant came out and started switching off all the lights, all the electricity in the house. And after switching it off, he went to rescue the child, and he was flung away by the electricity. And this child, 2 years old girl, was dying. This time, they said she was foaming in the mouth. Her eyes were changing. She was no longer breathing. And after that, the man managed again to get up and was able to, you know, pull the child out of this protector. I'm just sharing this testimony with us, so that especially we in Africa, please check your wiring in your house. Check your wiring in your house. Some electricians, they are very terrible. They are quacks. They are quacks. We never knew that was how my mom's house was wired all these years. And so they were able to pull the child out. Then she got burnt in her hands and her face. And this child was practically dead. She was not breathing. And the mother had to run out of the house, carry the child and run out to the main road. People gathered, and the child was not breathing. And they were saying her, telling her, already telling her, sorry. Oh, sorry, this child is dead. This child is dead. This child is dead. And my brothers came and they rushed the girl to the hospital. And the pastor came and they were praying. This child was just by miracle that God brought her back to life. God brought this girl back to life. I'm just so grateful for God, for his faithfulness, because I have prayed that in this year, I'm not going to bury any of my family members in the name of Jesus. And I pray for you also watching that you will not bury any members of your family this year. None of them shall die prematurely in the mighty name of Jesus. just because of quirk wiring. If you don't know how to do a job, I don't know why they will go and do a job. Imagine, how can an electrician wire the house? Instead of punching a hole in the wall to put the cables through, he put the cables through the protector and just put ordinary bedroom slippers to support it, to wedge it from touching the protector. Now the bedroom slippers is eaten and it is gone. If not, because of this carelessness, this child would have died. My niece would have died from electrocution. She actually almost died or died, but God brought her back to life. God brought her back. It was a miracle. When she came back to the area, everybody was just saying, this is a miracle. This is the work of God. I'm just so grateful. I want everyone to help me to thank God. Now she's recovered. She's recovered now. She's fully recovered. Back then, she had a lot, no blood, everything. You know, the electricity sucked her blood, but I thank God for his mercies. I thank God for his grace. I thank God for bringing her back to life. Thank God for what he's done in my family. I'm just here to say thank you, Jesus. I'm just here to glorify his name and also to let you guys know to please check that your wiring is properly done before all these quack electricians will kill our loved ones or tenants or people around us. And I pray that the Lord himself will continue to keep us. He will continue to preserve our lives. He will continue to protect us in the mighty name of Jesus. I am testifying to the goodness of God. See, if your time to die has not come, no devil can kill you. No power can kill you. Nobody has no power. No one has the right to take your life. Keep believing in him. Keep trusting in the Lord. If you don't know him, give your life to Jesus, because he's the only one that can preserve our lives. He's the only one that can save our lives. There is no other name under heaven by which we can be saved but the name of Jesus Christ. I pray that the Lord will bless you. I pray that the Lord will continue to protect us. I pray that the Lord will continue to preserve our lives in the name of Jesus. I pray for myself and my family, even as I pray for you, that we will not die before our time in the name of Jesus. And I cancel in the name of Jesus. I delete every spirit of premature death from our lives and the lives of our loved ones, the lives of our family in the name of Jesus. God bless you. God keep you. And may he continue to cause his face to shine upon you. In the remaining days, hours, minutes, seconds of this year, we will not hear any evil report in the name of Jesus. God bless you all. Have a wonderful evening. Bye-bye.